Hi guys, I'm in Bruges in Belgium and it's been raining a lot, but I've managed to catch a dry break, so I'm going to show you around the city. It's very beautiful, very old and very picturesque, like a postcard. So yeah, let's go sightseeing in Belgium. This, ladies and gentlemen, is Bruges' central market square, and the architecture is absolutely wonderful. And there is a wonderful smell of French fries in the air. There's food everywhere you turn in Belgium, or at least in Bruges. Guys, Belgian chocolate. Fantastic. Some of the best chocolate in the world here. So I'll come into a coffee shop in Belgium, and that's what's come with it is a nice little taster plate of Belgian praline chocolates. And this is actually just a cup of hot milk. But this is a dark Belgian chocolate from the chocolatier across the street, and I just put it in and stir it until it melts into the chocolate. Look at it, it won't even come off the spoon.
Just leave it in there and it'll melt.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah, just leave it in. Let's try one of these.
Ooh, it's crunchy.
Guys, if you do come to Bruges someday, I'm going to recommend one particular chocolatier to you, and that's this one here. It's called Dumont, and it's close to the bell tower, which you can just see over the rooftops there. So if you come from the main central market square and just down the Iron Market, was it?
Yeah.
Iron Market. Yeah. Then you just go to Dumont in here, and it's a family business. It's one of the cheaper chocolatiers in the city. And the chocolate is absolutely delicious, and they are the only ones I've seen which actually has stevia chocolates, sugar-free chocolates with stevia. So Dumont Chocolatier is highly recommended by me.
We're on a boat tour.
Bruges, your weather is not being particularly kind to us. Right, guys, this is the clock tower, and I'm going to attempt to climb its 366 steps for a view at the top, somewhere up there. This'll be fun and exhausting, but if I can do the Fushibi and Ai Shrine, I'm sure I can do this. This is pretty much how it is, guys. Just a very, very, very old stone tower with a long spiral staircase. This staircase is starting to get very, very narrow indeed. And very steep. Still a way to go. Okay, I'm told that I'm about halfway up. But this is the bell tower, I think. Look at the size of this thing. That's the chime. Whoa. How did they carry this up here?
You got a beard to end off with.
Yeah.
Guys, I'm not even zoomed in right now with the camera. This place is like a ladder. It's so steep. Ugh. And I'm pouring the sweat. I'm almost at the top. And finally, you squeeze through. It's quite windy in here, which is nice. More bells. And piece de resistance. Here is Bruges. I never walk near the edge. Used to fear falling. But when you give me love, when you give me love, I have. The deep blue sea, although it could drown me, I know it could drown me. And back down again, which is incredibly steep. Check this out, guys. Coffee and waffles in Bruges in the evening. Alright guys, this is Bruges by night. It's very pretty. Although I will admit there is not much open and not much to do. But it's really well lit. Some nice restaurants there. And over here we've got takeaway places. You can get things like kebabs or frites mayonnaise. Fountain looks pretty at night. Very nice indeed. Beautiful Bruges at night. Hi guys, today's the last day in Belgium and I've come into this capital of Belgium today, Brussels. So we've only got a couple of hours and the main thing I'm going to be doing is seeing the Atomium, which is one of Belgium's main landmarks. Should be pretty cool. That's the Atomium there, guys. That is pretty awesome. It's not just a monument, it's actually a building you can go inside. There's a restaurant and there's various exhibitions. Let's go and check it out. Here we are, guys, right at the very entrance. It's enormous. It's like Epcot, but more Big Bang Theory-ish. caught up. Well guys, here we are at the very top of the Atomium, and this is beautiful city Brussels, the capital of Belgium. That there is the Royal Palace of Belgium. That's where the King lives, I think. Maybe not where he lives, but... And here is a park. And over here are some council flats. So now we're on the escalator and we're going to go check out the other spheres of the Atomium. Resembled an inverted Eiffel Tower. Here's some pictures of the Atomium's construction in the 1950s. Here are some magazines from when the Atomium first opened in 1958. And this is what it looks like at night time. How is it, doggy? Apparently. This is what it looks like when a snake is looking at you. Hello. And it's raining again, of course. Ooh, funky escalator. Maybe next time I'll get to see the proper city of Brussels. It looks beautiful. Right guys, that is all from me here in Belgium. I've had a great time. It's been nice to visit a new country in Europe. And that's going to follow up very quickly with another one. Stay tuned, Slovenia is coming soon. Ciao for now, and don't forget to like, comment and subscribe if you enjoyed this tour of Belgium. Bye!